Yeah, we're now joined by Tom, Dougie, Harry and Danny, also known as McFly. Are you enjoying the show this morning?
Yes. Loving it. Yeah,
I like the Iceman.
He was great, wasn't
he? Yeah, he was really cool. Really
can we just have him back on?
Yeah, we want to talk to him forever, but we've got to talk to you. You got your ukulele, you're about to play that in a minute.
Maybe, yeah, I'm not very good. I kind of blag it at the moment when we have to play live.
Is that on one of the songs then?
Yeah, on the new song. I bought one a couple of months ago. I thought it'd be interesting to get a new instrument, try and write on it. And then
they only had pink ones left.
They only had a pink one left, so I got a pink one. And then I wrote a song on it, and I was like, now I'm going to have to play this in front of everyone, and I'm still not very good.
But you insisted on having a pink one in the video.
I kind of grew to love your
wooden one. Yeah, like, I want to use the pink one.
Yeah, I kind of grew to love it, really. It was the only one left in the shop.
But I hear that they're getting kids to do a lot of ukulele because they're quite easy to play. Is that true?
Well, I find it quite tricky because all the chords are different shapes to guitar. And I'm sure there's a technique which you're meant to use.
Go on then, bang something out for us.
I don't really know. That'd be a new one.
Yeah.
Today, I'm lapping the clouds away. I hear what the flowers say.
I'm in McFly.
That's what you have to do to be in the band, just clap.
Did I fit in?
Yeah,
I need some
right.
braces. I need some braces. So, you got our greatest hits album coming
out. We've got one for you. This is especially for you.
Hold on. And there you go, Simon.
Thank you. Cheers, Dan. Thank you.
Just for you.
Yes! Oh! I have made it into McFly. Yeah. Look,
trust me. What a picture that is.
Oh, yeah! Made it in. We've made it in.
Fit right.
We're in a band at last.
Yes.
So obviously you get asked this question so often. Greatest hit, splitting up.
Absolutely, yeah.
No. Yeah.
Last interview, after the show, it's all over. No, definitely not. I mean, it's, you know, we've been a band for 9.5 years. And this year's kind of been a year, like, we've reminisced a lot this year. We've had an autobiography out, and, you know, so all through the summer we were, you know, working on that. And so it just felt like the right time, really, to, you know, have a best of.
You know, when you started, and, like, it's a long time, 9.5 years, did you envisage it would last this long?
I genuinely believe that it's fate. McFly has made me believe in fate, because when I first got into the band, the guys said, yeah, Harry, want you to be in the band. My mum and dad were just like, you know what, we want you to stay at school. But I just had a feeling. I'd heard the songs they'd written, and I just had a feeling. And right from the word go, we've all...
Yeah, it's never been like a thing that we're like, oh, this is going to be a couple of year thing. We've always been in it for the long run.
Every year there's something that excites us and want to move on to the next
can't
album.
Can't wait to start doing new stuff. So.
The thing you can't guarantee, though, is having, you know, being able to have success. And, you know, a lot of our career is down to people, you know, the fans, people buying our records, coming to see us on tour, and, you know, that's something you can't guarantee.
You
so even if we wanted
fans.
To be a band forever, you know, it's not, it's
right,
down to people
you
wanting us to be a band.
You appreciate them more and more because you're still here.
Yeah, each year, you know, when we put a tour on sale, and you think it's amazing, like, stepping on stage and seeing that people still, after nearly 10 years, want to come and see us play. And
people say, oh, do you get sick of it, people asking for your autograph? I'm like, no, you know, until the day it stops, you know, I appreciate it, so.
He loves it.
Do you get sick of that?
Right,
we've
got a clip of your new song, let's have a look, here you go.
If this is love, then love is easy. It's the easiest thing to do. If this is love, then love completes me. Cause it feels like I've been missing you. A simple equation, but no complications to leave you confused. If this is love, 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 it's the easiest thing to do.
Got your sign upside down.
Yeah.
I think the thing about you guys is when you were on the reality TV shows, you could tell that you genuinely loved each other. You know, you genuinely like each other.
So many bands say, like, oh, we're best mates. So, like, I don't think I've ever met a band that are genuinely friends like we are.
Yeah.
Like, and people, I think, being, like, when they're on the reality shows, it's the first time people, you know, thought, oh, it's nice, you know, going down to support them. And, but it wasn't like just to, you know, publicity thing.
Going as
genuinely go as a friend to support them.
Well, the pitch invasion on Street.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
You made up your difference to Bruce Forsyth, yeah?
Yeah, I think he just thought we were like streakers or something.
He was whacking them with his cue cards, wasn't he?
For anyone who doesn't know, when you won, they all ran on, didn't
they? They all ran on. Yeah, these three and my brother ran on and stormed the stage, and Bruce Forsyth
didn't like it.
He didn't know. He was like, who are they? Who are they? Get off the stage! Get off! And he was whacking. You know the corner of the cue card, he's whacking them on the head.
Give me a little dead arm.
Yeah, and
I think Brucey could have been quite handy in his day. Right, there's this new book out. Who's written this?
That's our autobiography.
Tom, Danny, you've written this.
Me and Dougie did. Yeah, it's a kids book. Dinosaur That Pooped Christmas. It started off as a bit of a, like, we go into bookshops all the time when we're writing our albums to kind of get inspiration.
Not
books like that though, to get inspiration for our album.
But we'd always end up like in like the picture book section and just be like, oh, there's so many kids' books out that are just like, you know, think, oh, that could be so much better if it was like this, you know, if it had a bit of poop in it or a dinosaur here and there. And we just thought, oh, we'd give it a go. And
you can tell boys have written it because of the dinosaur that pooped at Christmas.
Yeah, yeah. I think it's triple. It's three things that like that we find funny in kids' love: Christmas, dinosaurs, and poop.
Yeah. Put them all together.
Win, win, win.
You're playing at the end of the show, right?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Bang that tune for us. Right, coming up, we're getting serious with some sausage-making skills. See you in a bit.